had a little bit of a disconnect on that last first recording. I'm going to try another start on a second live recovery or live recording. It's Thursday morning, June 4th, looking at John chapter 7, verse 1, and John chapter 7, verse 7. This is a little introduction to this coming Sunday when our church reopens. I want to invite all of you to join us at 9:30 Sunday morning for a blended worship, family included, and 11 o'clock contemporary worship, family included. We will practice social distancing, and if you want to wear a mask, wear a mask. We'll do our very best to, if we need for overflow, we have an overflow room that's available. There will be sanitizing stations. We'll do all that we can to protect everyone, so join us, if you would, this coming Sunday. As we reopen our church, we regather around the theme of Aloha. So I want to just give an introduction right now for the sermon this coming Sunday and the following Sunday, June 14th. So out of John chapter 7, verse 1, and John chapter 7, verse 7, there's some themes that are going on in these verses. One is violence. Jewish people are clearly plotting to kill Jesus. Jesus, being God, knows that the plot is thickening, that there is a movement against him. Jesus is in Galilee, and there's an interesting little word in there about walking. Jesus walked all over Galilee and Judea and Samaria in Israel. I'm out walking right now, just enjoying the walk, and we have people walking as well and riding bikes. And when I think about this passage, John chapter 7, verse 1, there's a turning point in the book of John, and literally prior, John chapter 6, and prior books in the book of John, chapters, the Jewish people are grumbling. They're mad. They're angry. But in John chapter 7, verse 1, the text now says the death penalty. They're seeking literally to kill. So when you think about the violence there, what you have is premeditated murder. It's a wicked violence. And Jesus is walking, and Jesus is moving all over the country, and he's getting the word out. He's about love. He's not about hate. As a matter of fact, you find that word hate down in verse 7, John 7, 7. The world hates Jesus. Back up in John 7, 1, the Jewish people are seeking to kill Jesus. So friends, just take a moment and think about what the Bible just said in the context of all the violence today, whether that be a violent act by a police officer against a man, a black man, or whether that be violence by rioting and looting and stealing and killing other people. Jesus and his followers, Christians, are clearly to be marked by love, not hate. Jesus came to earth to advance the notion of love one another, to the point that he said, love your enemies, to the point that Jesus was teaching constantly, turn the other cheek. We're living in a world that is as in Jesus' world, was filled with hate. And just as there were people in Jesus' world that were seeking to kill him, why? Because they hated him. They hated him because they did not believe in him. And we get wrapped up in a negative ideology because I don't agree with you. As a matter of fact, I don't believe you. I don't like what you say. I don't want to follow you. Matter of fact, I'm against you to the point that I hate you. And that hate was born in John chapter 6 in the great manifesto of chapter 6 of John by Jesus. Literally, they started grumbling. He performs miracles. Jesus offers to the food, the bread, the manna. But it's more than that. If you follow Jesus Christ and you are loyal to Jesus, the symbolic teaching of Jesus is you will feast on Jesus. You will devour Jesus, not in violence, but in learning and in obeying Jesus. And Jesus' command is love one another. But in John chapter 7, verse 1, now we see the Jewish people seeking to kill Jesus. John chapter 7, verse 1 is now a straight, aggressive slide to crucifixion, which will come later in the book of John. All of this is built on hate, on not believing in Jesus. And even his brothers did not believe. We'll talk more about that this coming Sunday. But when you think about the violence in America, you have to stop and say, where's the love? Where's the compassion? Where's the gentleness? Where's the kindness? And friends, all of this hate is being pressurized because of a lack of justice. That's what's being said. And I think that is the case in some cases. But friends, it may not be all about justice. The Jewish people didn't believe in Jesus. The Jewish people did not agree with Jesus. They hated him because they didn't believe in him. So there may be justice, and I believe Jesus was a just man. I don't believe there was any reason for the Jewish people to justify killing him. But they did. So you can have the perfect person loving other people as Jesus did. And in John chapter 6, he just did a miracle of feeding 5,000. He did the miracle of walking on the water. So friends, in an ideology of hate and violence, Jesus was crucified because they didn't believe in him. They didn't believe in him because Jesus was different. Jesus said that the Father sent him. Jesus said that him and the Father are one. Jesus said, in essence, that he's God. And they didn't like that ideology. They hated the fact that Jesus claimed to be God. They would welcome his bread. They would welcome his fish. They would welcome, as long as Jesus met their physical needs. But you have to back up and understand this Jesus was a man of compassion, a man of gentleness, of grace, of mercy. He would give. But the people, the Jewish people, they just kept grumbling and griping because they would not buy into the fact that Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus is promoting what the Father had said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him would not perish but have everlasting life. So in this world that we live in today, there are many, many injustices, and that should not be. Whether that be by a police officer or whether that be by any other human being stealing and looting, and out of somehow this mindset that I will seek revenge. I'll take justice into my own hands. The Jewish people did that to Jesus, and it led to crucifixion. As we live our lives every day, we have to come back and say and believe and do what Jesus said and believed and did. Don't get caught up in hate. Hate doesn't solve any problem. It just makes problems. Be real careful what comes out of your mouth. Just as the Jewish people were constantly agitating Jesus is just simply speaking the truth in love, but he doesn't return back with hate. Even though they're seeking to kill him, he doesn't get mad. He doesn't get revenge because he knows the Father is at work. Jesus, it's interesting in John chapter 7, verse 1, that his brothers turn against him. They have not believed prior to this point. Jesus has several half-brothers, not Christians at this time. They're not disciples. They're family members. They're siblings. And they begin to agitate Jesus. They begin to challenge Jesus. Go down to Jerusalem. Go to the Feast of Tabernacles. And there, make more miracles, basically. Talk about who you are so your disciples will believe in you, so people will follow you. Go public, Jesus. And Jesus says, no, now's not the time. God, my Father, has a plan. And Jesus keeps walking in Galilee. And the brothers go on down to the Feast of Tabernacles in Jerusalem. There's an interesting sovereignty of God and free will of man at work in John chapter 7, 1 to 9. When you look at John chapter 7, verse 1 and John chapter 7, verse 9, or verse 7, you see that man can be hateful. Man has the freedom to hate. As a matter of fact, man has the freedom to kill. Man has the freedom to do violence. But that's not what Jesus wants. Jesus is constantly encouraging people to love. Speak the truth in love. So I want to encourage you as we take a step forward toward this coming Sunday, when our church for almost, 3 months almost, campus has been closed, but the church itself has been open. Can I just encourage you, follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Don't hate, love. Follow the Father, follow Jesus. Violence is real, and Jesus knew that if he went to Jerusalem, there was going to be bloodshed there because the Jews were seeking to kill him, and he chose not to go there. And I just remind you, stay away from trouble. You know there's trouble when you say that, when you go there, when you do that. If you're trying to agitate or solicit or get people riled up or get trying to do something wrong, that's not what Jesus did. You can speak the truth in love. I wholeheartedly, Martin Luther pushed America to peaceful protest when an injustice has occurred. And I believe at this point in time, based upon the evidence that I've seen, it does look like a police officer and perhaps other officers committed an injustice against a man, a black man. And we as individuals must allow justice to move. There must be an ongoing investigation, and there is. And we must patiently wait for the wheels of justice turn slow. In peacefully protest. Peacefully protest. Jesus never backed away from speaking the truth in love. This coming Sunday, as you come, we want to encourage you to 9:30 blended. Bring family and friends and relatives, neighbors, enemies. 11 o'clock is contemporary. Bring the whole family, the whole neighborhood. Our services will be short. They won't be long. They simply will try our best to, as people come in, we'll encourage social distancing. If you need a mask, there will be masks available. You don't have to wear a mask, but the masks are available. There's hand sanitizer stations that are available this Sunday. We'll be 6 foot social distancing practicing. Every other row of chairs in the worship center will be blocked off. We want to lift up the Lord Jesus Christ and also protect one another. Lots of things that we're doing. We're sanitizing the bathrooms constantly. We're cleaning in the worship center between services. Golf carts will be running in the parking lot. They'll be sanitizing. People at the door will be sanitizing and opening the door for you. We will enjoy communion. It's Aloha theme. I already have a Hawaiian shirt that my wife Diana bought me, and I'll wear that. We have some welcoming of the love of God, which is welcome and love is what Aloha is all about. Love one another. So I want to encourage you as you're moving, maybe already the day, maybe some of you are still sleeping, but this is a great day. It's Thursday, June 4th, and John chapter 7, verse 1 and verse 7 are two powerful verses that show a contrast of how Jesus lives his life and how the world hates Jesus. And please don't get caught up in the violence of life. Jesus was at peace. You remember the Bible says, be at peace with every person as much as you can. On your side of the ledger, peace is a big deal. We're all looking for that peace. And I just want to encourage you. I'm now in a park and just got into a big, nice shade tree. See if I can, and it's really cooled down. A couple of kids with parents, lots of walkers and bikers, nobody on the volleyball court, nobody on the basketball court. God is at work. Justice will prevail. The Father is going to bring correction. The sovereignty of God is amazing, but God in his sovereignty created the free will of man. But we must manage that free will. We must choose not to do violence. We must watch carefully what comes out of our mouth. So today, it's a great day. It's a day to get up and smile. I enjoy the birds. I'm watching sprinklers in the park, water sprinklers going. There's a few cars out. The sun is up. It's starting to warm up. I think it's probably closer to 7:30 now. It's a beautiful day. You have a good day. Blessings on you.